If you play the hi-hat on your e-kit and notice the wrong instrument is being triggered, or maybe you aren't hearing anything at all, you can easily remap your hi-hat in SSD 5.5 using this quick tip. If you have a popular drum module, like the Mimic Pro, Roland TD-30, or Elisa Strike, go to the Map tab and select Load Preset. Select the preset that matches your e-kit and click Open. If your preset isn't listed, you can quickly create custom mapping presets that work for your unique setup. From the map window, you'll see all of the available articulations and where they're currently mapped. In this example, I'm playing the hi-hat, but I'm triggering the toms instead of the hi-hat articulations. I see that my hi-hat is playing values G-sharp 3, F-sharp 3, and E3 when my hi-hat is fully open, fully closed, and when I'm using the hi-hat pedal. These values will likely be different for you depending on what e-kit you're playing. To find what values your hi-hat is currently playing, just look at the software while you're playing the hi-hat in each position. You'll see the note value turn blue when it's played. Since my hi-hat is currently playing the wrong articulations, I'm going to find the correct articulations I want to remap. First, I'll find the hi-hat tip open 3 and click on the MIDI Learn button. I'm going to hit the hi-hat in the open position on my e-kit. And now, my hi-hat open position should be mapped correctly. Let's do the same for hi-hat tip closed. For this one, make sure you already have your hi-hat in the closed position without moving the hi-hat pedal. Because if you use your hi-hat pedal, you might accidentally remap the hi-hat closed articulation to your hi-hat pedal instead, which we don't want in this case. Now let's click the MIDI Learn button in SSD, then hit the hi-hat closed on your e-kit. And finally, let's remap the hi-hat pedal. Here's the hi-hat pedal articulation, which is currently assigned to note C4. Just hit the MIDI Learn button and close the hi-hat pedal without hitting the hi-hat pad to remap. Now when you play your hi-hat, it should be playing the correct hi-hat articulations. And if you want to use different articulations than the one I use in this example, you can do that using the same process. Your newly remapped articulations will appear in yellow to show that they've been customized. Once you have your hi-hat remapped, click the Save Preset button, title your preset, then hit Save. If you ever need to load this preset in the future, just hit the Load Preset button and locate your custom preset. Hopefully this resolves any issues you've had with your hi-hat mapping. And for more tips and tricks, be sure to subscribe to Steven Slate Audio.